So let's talk about rational exponents. So rational, that means to say we're going to see fractions, okay, in our exponents. So for instance, today I'm going to show you how to simplify expressions like 4 to the 1 half, let's say negative 8 to the 1 third. Okay, how do we simplify these types of expressions? Well, actually we define, let's say if I have a real number a raised to the 1 over n, okay, we define this to be the nth root of a, okay? Well, let's assume that, you know, a is something that's valid, okay? Well, I'll show examples of what I mean by this. So, using this definition, let's say if I want 4 to the half, 4 to the half simply means the square root of 4. So, that 2 there becomes that index 2 in our radical, okay? And of course, by now we know that the square root of 4 is 2, okay? Likewise, if I have negative 8 to the 1 third, then that means to say that's the cube root of negative 8, okay? And we know that cube root of negative 8 is negative 2, right? When you multiply negative 2 3 times, you get negative 8. Now, what do I mean by a should make the expression okay? So, for instance, if I have, let's say, negative 16 raised to the 1 fourth, okay, so following this definition, this would be the fourth root of negative 16. And hopefully by now you know that we cannot take the even index root of, I don't know how to say that, okay, but you cannot take the square root, the fourth root, the sixth root of something that's negative, right? Because, yeah, you cannot have an even number of factors that will give you a negative answer, okay? So this one won't work, okay? This is not a real number. Okay? Anyway, so that's what we do, okay? And of course, we can play with these. Oh, wait, before I leave this example, it's a different story if I have negative 16 to the 1 fourth, okay? Negative 16 to the 1 fourth, I hope now you know that really the negative is not included in raising to the 1 fourth. It's really just the 16 that you're raising to the 1 fourth. So you have to keep that negative sign, all right? And write this using the definition as the fourth root of 16, okay? And you know fourth root of 16 is, well, you have 4 times 4, then you have your 4 twos, right? So the fourth root of 16 is 2, but then we have that negative sign sitting outside, so your answer is negative 2, okay? So make a note of the difference here. Here the negative is included in raising to the 1 fourth. Here the negative is outside, okay? It's only the 16, the number 16 that you're raising to the 1 fourth. So hopefully that's clear how to interpret the rational expression 1 over an integer, right? 1 over a positive integer. All right, so what's the next thing? Well, we can play with these expressions and have something like, yeah, I said positive, then I remembered we also dealt with negative exponents. So what if I have, let's say, 8 to the negative 1 third? What does that mean? What do you think we should do with this first? Well, using the rule, a to the negative n is equal to 1 over a to the n, right? We have to write this first as 1 over 8 to the 1 third, all right? And now for this one, you can apply the definition, which is a to the 1 third is really the cube root of 8, okay? And so therefore, you have 1 half, okay? Your next question is, what about if the base is a fraction, right? So for instance, if I have 4 ninths, that's a fraction, and I want to raise it, let's say, to the half, okay? So let's take a simple example. So following the definition that I introduced today, this means really that's index 2, so you want the square root of 4 over 9, right? And we learned that to take the square root of a quotient, you just do it one at a time, right? So square root of 4 is 2, square root of 9 is 3, okay? So if I have, yeah, if I have a negative base, let's say I have negative 8 over 27, and let's say this is raised to the third, right? It's okay if that's, because that's going to be index 3, right? So you'll have the cube root of negative 8 over 27, all right? So what's going to happen here? You can take the cube root one at a time, right? So you get the cube root of, you can apply that negative sign either to the 8 or the 27, doesn't matter, okay? So if you apply it to the 8, so you're thinking of the number negative 8, what number do you multiply 3 times to get negative 8? And you know you have 3 2's there, right? But you need 3 negative 2's, so you'll have negative 2 on top, right? And then 27 is really 3 3's, right? 3 times 3 times 3, cube root of the 3 3's is 3. So you have negative 2 over 3, and hopefully by now, if you look at the back of the book and you see me write negative 2 over 3 with a negative in front of the fraction, it's the same thing. Unless the least popular, of course, is you write it as 2 over negative 3, but these three are all equivalent answers, okay? So that's how we deal with fractions. I guess maybe you want me to explain what about if I have a negative exponent, all right? So if I have, let's say I have 81 over 16, and I have this raised to the negative 1/4, okay? 81 over 16 to the negative 1/4. Again, we appeal to that rule, which is a to the negative n is equal to 1 over a to the n. But I think I explained a while back, right, that if you have a fraction and the exponent is negative, really all you need to do is what? Yes, get the reciprocal of the fraction. The reciprocal of the fraction is 16 over 81, and change that negative exponent to positive, so you have 1/4, okay? So now this means to say you're really getting the 4th root of 16 over 81, right? Okay, and by now hopefully you know how to break this down, so you know that you'll get 4 2's from 16, right? So therefore out will come 1, right? And you can do the work for that. 81 will be what? It's 4 3's rather, right? It's 9 times 9, so you see 4 3's and you get 3 out, okay? So that's how you deal with these fractional exponents, all right? Of course, I explained only the simple case, namely what? The numerator is always 1, right, in the fraction. So the next thing we're going to talk about is, what about if I have numerator different from 1, like 3, 2, whatever, okay? So that's what's going to hit us next.